almost all the way around the chair and ready to put on the big piece of fabric. So, anybody out there from Louisiana watching? Gonna be in Louisiana in April for a workshop in Chauvin. I think I finally learned how to say that word. Chauvin, Louisiana. Thank you, Tracy Windley, for the video on how to pronounce towns in Louisiana. That was pretty funny. She shared a video with me. And Carly has been sharing pictures of the area with me. She's got one of her cousins has a shrimp boat, which I think Bill's gonna try to put that up for you. So there's a picture of the shrimp boat that her cousin owns, which is near where we're gonna be. She said she lives right in the area. And her family also owns a marina. Oh, this is actually a sculpture garden that is near her house that I'm hoping we have time to see. We've actually planned the trip, so I'm spending the day Sunday with some of the ladies and we're gonna go touring New Orleans. Because I've never been down there before. So that picture was a sculpture garden that's near her house. Let's see, this one I think is too short. Yeah, too short. Too close for comfort. I'm not going to cut it that short. And these were just scrap pieces from when I cut out the section for the skirts, trying to do the pattern placement on the skirt that I had this area in between, so we were able to use them up. But yeah, so I'm looking forward to going to Chauvin for the workshop, and the girls have been teasing me because they're going to feed me crawfish, which I don't know if I'll like, or crayfish. How do you say it, Tracy? Crayfish or crawfish? I think it's crayfish. And they're all telling me that they're going to show me how to eat them, but it's like here, we have lobsters, so you know, they're a lot bigger than crayfish. And I know they have lobsters too, but they've been teasing me about that. All right, last piece here. Oops, did I run out of staples? Nope. I guess it did staple. Looked like it came out. It's kind of like a spool of, or a bobbin thread when you're sewing and you run out of bobbin. Same thing happens with staples. All right, fold this edge over. Stapled. Three more cuts and we're on to the next piece of fabric. One down. Try to get this up in there. There we go. It's hard to hang on to that one for some reason. And get these last two cuts made. Get this on and then get to the main piece. And without shifting it left to right, get this one cut. And I'll put a close-up picture of this out there later so you can really see how this wraps around here. Because I know with the camera it's hard to see it right now. Lift this up out of the way. I don't need all of this. Don't cut the tape measure, Kim. We did that one day. I had a tape measure, cloth tape measure laying on the table. I was working on something and Bill came up and threw something on the table that he needed to cut and didn't see the tape measure. So after he finished cutting what he was cutting, I think my cloth tape measure was in four pieces. So be careful where you lay those down. All right, so there you have it. The outside edge is all done all the way around. That wasn't too bad, was it? All those little cuts, and now we get to make them all over again from the other side of the chair. And this part's gonna be a little more difficult because we can't get exactly where we need to be angle of our body-wise to get the cuts. So it's gonna be a little more patience and just like really making sure that you get the cuts in the right place. So Bonnie says, I've never seen this type of application before, so this is very interesting. And Janet says, hi Janet, and hi Amy. Amy's having lunch. Susan says, it looks like you are making a single cut to the spindle and forming a folded V shape. Is that right? Yes, that's exactly right, Susan. That's exactly what I'm doing. Tracy just finished a sofa. And Nikki says the feed is great. Janice says, good now, but I hadn't interrupted before and had to watch it from my phone. So Debbie says, hello, sorry for the cough, guys. Hello, Crystal and Jana, thanks for, or Jana rather, thanks for joining us. And Ann, thanks for hopping in. All right, are we ready? Are we ready to do the main piece? Nah, we don't want to make all these cuts, do we? Let's just forget it and go, just put a cushion on top of it and be done. All right, so let's position this. I got my center marked there. Goes between those spindles in the back. This is the center of the chair. This is the center in the front. The pot looks straight up and down. So I'm gonna go ahead and get a couple staples in the front just to hold the front in position and then start making our cuts. And I think what I'm gonna do is go like left to right and keep going back and forth and work my way out. I think that makes the most sense. I've never done one exactly like this with all these cuts either, so let's learn this one together. And that's one thing in this field is, I mean, you know the skills, you know the techniques, but every piece gives you a different challenge. And as long as you understand the skills and the concepts, you can do just about any piece of furniture. And you really can. It's just once you get those concepts down, you got it. All right, so smoothing it back, I'm gonna make the first cut on the left here. Folding this fabric back. So I'm folding up against the post and we'll make our cut. Oops, I actually gotta shift the fabric that way a hair. Oops, you know what? I got a little tail there from the other fabric that's making a bump. So let me get that out of there. It's at the same point of where I stapled the dacron, so just don't want the excess bulk sticking up in there. Because it would come back to haunt you. Okay, let's go for it. Ready? And then when we wrap around the post, we'll create the folds. And I'm going to go ahead and get a temporary staple under this side. I'm making it a temporary one just in case. And just checking the other side. That looks good. So now before I staple this center piece down here, I want to make this cut so that this fabric is free to come down and attach. So turn the chair back around so I can get at the front. And now I've got that one side attached so I know I'm not going to pull it. And you really want to take your time doing this because this is where everything can go wrong really fast. How many of you have had made that dreaded cut and then you're like, oh, now I gotta take that whole fabric off? I think Karen was working on a chair recently. I don't know if she's watching today in our group, and she was talking about how cutting the front arms around the front arm posts was so difficult and easy to go wrong. I think she said she had to do it once or twice. And that happens, you know, when you're learning, that's part of the process. Okay, so that one is good, even though it's not getting out of my way here. All right, so I'm going to turn this back around, get that center part stapled, and then we'll move on to the next one. You just want to be really neat when you're doing this and fold it neatly so everything lays smooth in the end. All right, so now we have the very center attached. So I'll go ahead and do one to the left and then come back and do one to the right. And at this point, your fabric is all cockeyed, so you really got to pay attention. And you know what? I think I'm going to need to lift this edge to get that stapled better. So that temporary staple, which is why I made it temporary, it's because I knew I was going to need to take it out. I just kind of forgot when I had the chair back here. So let me get down where I can see it. Where are you, staple? Let me move this off. And if you know you're going to have to make an adjustment, using temporary staples will save you from digging everything out. There we go. So it was much easier to remove because it was temporary. Okay, so now we can flip that up and then I can see better to make that other cut. Don't make your work more difficult. much easier. And now I'll be able to get this piece completely attached. And any excess I have hanging at the bottom will trim later. I always tell my students, cut your pieces a little bit bigger than you think you need, because I'd rather waste 3 inches than realize I cut it too small and waste a whole piece of fabric. All right, so now we'll go over this way. And because I've got it anchored in the front, I know that I'm not pulling it too far that way as well. And this is a lot of going back and forth, and that's when this table comes in really handy, because I can just spin it around. Right, fold those edges under. My hands to work. There we go. I don't know if you can see close enough. Maybe you can if I had it over here. So if I tip the chair, yeah, you really can't tell from the camera there. You can see where that little piece of underneath fabric shows between those folded cut edges.
Hold on a second, I might be able to.
Bill's gonna try to zoom in for you. I think it's the other camera, Bill. Try to zoom in so you can see. There you go. So now I go, whoops. If I can coordinate myself, so if I go this way, so there you can see it right here. Which one am I at? Right here's the little piece of fabric that we attached first, and these are the folded edges of what I'm doing for the seat. So you can see that all you need, once you get your skirt on, all I was doing was covering that little piece on top there. But it gives a much better finish in the end, so it's worth the extra effort to do those little details. And I got a little thread sticking up, which we'll poke back down later with a regulator. This won't work. Nope, that worked. So, all right, so we just did this one. Now I'll do one more over here. And we'll go back to the other side. And I am trying to look at the grain of the fabric too at this point. Actually, you know what? I think I am actually going to get this cut first, because then this fabric will lay nicer for me to get in there and work. So let me go around the other side and lower this a little bit, because now I need to get lower so I can get myself in there. I've got to push my pedestal down. There we go. That should work. So now the best angle for me is to be directly across from where I'm cutting. I'm going to do two of these so that I can get this piece in the center attached, which will hold it better while I do that other cut. So I won't have so much leeway for the fabric to shift. Now I get that pulled around. And now we can come back here. Now I'm just double checking this is how it's going to work. I think this one is actually going to be better if I draw this out, because it's got a funky angle here, and if I cut this wrong, we're going to be starting over. We don't want that, do we? I don't want that. All right, so the grain of the fabric, and this look is going to look really awkward. The grain of the fabric is straight there, but I think if I do that, so then if I take, I've drawn my line, and I hold it up on the post. Where is it? Right there. And I believe that is going to give me what I need to fold over. All right, so let's go for it. Fingers crossed. And this is where you really got to just pay attention to the frame of the chair and what you're doing. And I talk about all this in the cuts videos on our website. Are we ready? Yes, we have enough. Yay! There we go, finished edges. Perfect. But had I cut that piece before I had this other attached, I probably would have ended up pulling the fabric too far and being off in the end. So, all right, so now this piece comes between here and there's those folds. That's where you really, and that's like I always say, let the fabric tell you what it wants to do. And if you listen to, watch the grain, look at the frame of the chair, and you've got to walk through your head of where the fabric's going to go, you'll get there. All right, so now we go ahead and make this last cut on this side, and then we go do the same thing over there. Those are big scissors. Those are my 12-inch width scissors. Those are my heavy-duty ones. Keep running over my hose here. All right, pull this down. Get this little thread hanging. Get that stapled. And now I could actually go ahead and finish this whole corner right here. So I might get just a couple staples to hold it while we go to the other side, but I'm not going to do all of it right now. But that'll keep it from shifting left to right. So now I'll go back to that awkward cut over here too. So again, I'm going to do the side posts first. There's always one side of the chair that is easier than the other just because whether you're left or right-handed, and this is my hard side here. And it's just more awkward to get in here and cut from this direction. Get it attached. All right, and again, I'm going to draw this cut out. I draw it out and then I just check myself. Holding the pencil line up. Yep, that will work. Give me what I need. I'm liking this fabric too. It's really pretty. It's got a nice hand too. This would make a nice slip cover. Looks like I could get that a little bit deeper, but I'll get the staple down first. Actually, this one looks like it could be a little deeper. Just a smidge. There, that's better. One of those things, when you catch it, do it then, because it's hard to go back and change it. And once you had the skirt on, you'd be committed. Yeah, so I can see that these both need to be a smidge deeper. Fold the raw edges under. And this too. And it literally was like an eighth of an inch or less, so you want to just go slowly when you're at that point. All right, one cut left to do. Again, you want to keep yourself in a good angle. You don't want to try to contort your body to do this. You want to really get to where you can see what you're doing. You don't want to like force the cut. So is anybody sharing what other things they're working on? Anybody got any questions?
Yeah, once you finish that, we'll switch to the questions.
Okay, so let me get this last part attached here around the front, and then we'll switch to the questions. These type of pieces, when you're making all these cuts, definitely you want to be in the right frame of mind. If you're having a bad day, that's not the day to do something like this. Go do something else and come back to this later, because if you're frustrated or having one of those days where things aren't going right, these cuts could easily go wrong, as you can see. All right, I get a couple staples under here, and then to actually finish off this corner, I need to flip the chair upside down, so we'll do that after. Although maybe not, maybe these pleats are going to work out really well from this angle. There. So I just got to finish attaching that last front corner there, but that whole seat is done. And once I trim the bottom, it's good to go. So let's go look at your questions and comments and see what we've got that have come in while I was working here. Hello, Crystal. Thanks for joining. Hello, Kathy. Nikki said, is your Dacron attached down at all, or will it pretty much stay in place between the support of the fabric? I actually put one staple in the front, Nikki, and one staple in the back to keep it from shifting around. And the rest of it is just the weight of the fabric holding it in place. Hello, Patty. Thanks for joining us. And Debbie says, I am working on an antique rocking chair. Had to remove the arms to repair them. Should I put them back before upholstering them and the back? Post a picture in the group, Debbie. I'm not sure. It's hard to answer that without seeing the chair frame. If you were able to get all the upholstery off without removing the arms, you probably need to put them back on, though. But post a picture in the group. Ann says, how close to the spindle do you make your cuts? I am literally like a 16th of an inch from the spindle when I make those cuts, so that way when I fold the fabric over, it's got just enough of an edge to cover the raw edges. And on the side, I probably had about a quarter of an inch to fold under, but at the front of the post, it is like right there. Nikki says, it looks gorgeous around the curved back. Thank you. Penny says, hi Kim, I got the Chervan order, thanks. You are welcome, I'm glad you were happy with it. Hopefully you'll post pictures for us when you get it all done. Hey Sue, thanks for joining, haven't seen you in a while. And Ann says, do you think it would look okay without a skirt? Actually, I think it would. You could actually go ahead and trim this down nicely, put your dust cover on, and you wouldn't need a skirt, but she did want the skirt put back on. Thanks. I guess that's it on Facebook. Not a lot of questions today. Is anybody working on any like funky projects, anything out of the ordinary you'd want to share with us? I'd love to see what you're all working on. So as you can see, something that looks like a simple seat in the beginning, we've been doing this for, 50 minutes. So it took about 50 minutes to attach this seat. So even though it looks like a quick, easy, simple job, it really takes some time. Hi, Herbert. Thanks for joining us today. And Linda. So we've got Facebook and YouTube, so thank you everybody for hopping in. So next what I need to do is sew the cording for this, so we can get the cording sewn that gets stapled around the frame, and then I'll flip the chair on its back afterwards and get this tweaked and trimmed down, so I won't try to do the trimming with it standing up in this position. So let me hop over to the sewing machine now, and Bill will switch cameras for you so that you can come over and see that. So I've got my cording strips all cut, and over my head is a spool of cording, so I just pull the cording down from over my head. And I've already gone ahead and changed the thread on this machine to the right color. And this is falling off, so I might as well just, take it off. My wheels are spinning here. And this isn't the machine that we had that funny video from the student in. This is the one that has the slower motor. But that was funny. Poor Karen. She was like, whoa! So I've got a quarter-inch cording foot on the sewing machine. This is the Juki DNU 1541S walking foot machine that I use for this. And sometimes I get that to stay under the table, and other times it doesn't. But once I get going, it's easy to maneuver. And with this right here, I can just like keep sewing. Once I get going, yeah, just kind of keep on going. And you can tell, for those of you that don't have industrial machines, that these industrial machines can go pretty fast. And this one is actually set to a slower speed. So you can imagine what it looks like at full bore. Luckily, I don't drive as fast as I sew, though, right?
You do.
I knew Bill was going to say that. Bill says, you do. I do not. Only once in a while. All right, so there is our piece of cording all sewn up for the chair. And now we'll go ahead and attach it, staple it on the chair edge. I'll have to finish that corner because it didn't take me as long as I thought it would. And we'll get that attached. So let's hop back over to the chair, Bill. I have, what did I do with the blanket? Let's just shift this stuff for a second so I can lay the chair on its back. And I'm going to put this cushion underneath it to protect the wood. And that way I can go ahead and finish these corners here. And actually add a few more staples here and there where I didn't. Whoops, and I'm out of staples. And I used 3/8 inch staples for this whole process. Metal on the chair there, and I have to pull that out after. Staple kicked back on me a little bit. And this worked out good. The way this curve is, all the folds pull to the bottom. I don't have any folds that show up on the face of the chair. Not that they'd show up in the end anyway. A few more around the back too here, and then we'll go ahead and trim it. This is when you get these underneath spindles, it's awkward to get your gun in here sometimes, or rungs rather, I guess they call the rungs of the chair. There we go. For some reason it wasn't shooting. I guess there's something metal underneath the chair there. And I think that's it. All right, so now we'll go ahead and trim this down. I don't trim anything down until I'm 100% sure that it's staying put. So if you're working on a chair and you're getting ready to close it up, once I get to the point of closing it up is when I trim down everything when you're working on a fully upholstered piece, because it's oftentimes you'll find some little thing that you need to tweak. And if you've already trimmed it, it just makes your life a little more difficult. move this and roll the chair on that cushion a little bit so we can get to the other side. Oops. Actually, I see where I need one more staple. Maybe two, maybe three. And right here at the leg, I'm going to have to come back in with smaller scissors later and get that really close so that it's not folded up on the leg of the chair. You just want to always be careful of the decorative wood too, so that you're not dinging it up as you go. All right, so here we go. We have it all trimmed and we are ready for the cording, which will have to happen next week because it is at the end of our hour. So for those of you that are members to our online classes, don't forget we will be live with the Q&A session this afternoon at 3 o'clock. You can go ahead and get questions in early in the chat if you want, or come in live with us on camera. And for everybody else, thank you so much for spending the time, or for all of you, thank you so much for spending time with us today. And we look forward to seeing you right back here next week. I did want to tell them something, though. Can I tell them that one thing I forgot? I got so busy. Okay, so we got a minute. You don't mind if I go a couple minutes over. So in May, we have a special guest coming in to do a project live with us right here. And if you have seen my post earlier in, I think last week, Kristen Nichols, or Nicholas rather, who lives in this area, has printed this book and it has written this book and it is coming out this month to be available for purchase. And she is actually going to come and do one of the projects out of her book right with us live here at Kim's Upholstery for our Wednesday live. So that'll be in the middle of May. This chair on the front of the book is actually a chair that I upholstered for Kristen out of her fabric. So it made the front cover, and you never know what's going to be on the cover because the publishers are the ones that pick the cover. And then inside her book, she talks about the fabric she designs through Spoonflower, and that's a slipcover that I did for her chair out of her Spoonflower fabric. So if you have ever checked on Spoonflower, go check out, look for Kristen Nicholas. You can see her different designs that she has on there, and she'll bring some to share with us as well. So stay tuned for more details about that, but she will be here in May, and she has several other books that are really inspiring. But this one is called Crafting a Patterned Home. So she will be with us. And it's going to be fun. Her and I have a good time when we're together. So again, thank you for spending time with us, and I look forward to seeing you all next week. So have a good afternoon.